number 24, Ariel Malone.
Back at Rochester High School for the starting lineups, first the Peru Tigers. They are 1-3 overall, 0-1 of the TRC. That one guard will be a 5'6 senior, Drew Thompson. The other guard, a 5'6 freshman, Cortland Crow. That one forward, a 5'8 junior, Lindley Prescott. The other forward, a 5'7 junior, Ariel Malone. And the third forward tonight will be a 5'7 sophomore, Harmony Stone. Peru coach for Mr. David Weeks. For the Rochester Zebras, that one guard will be a 5'5 junior, Maddie Shively. The other guard, a 5'6 junior, Morgan Ruff. At one forward, a 5'7 sophomore, Karina Peterson. At the second forward, a 6'2 junior, Kennedy Musselman. And at the third forward position will be 6' junior, Emma Dahlquist, Rochester coach, the Mr. Tony Stasiak. Well, if there's ever a time that Rochester, Brad, needed a win, tonight's the night.
Yeah, I think so. You know, after that rough first week, this will be a good one to get started. Your first conference game, get out on a good note. Peru's going to match up pretty evenly with Rochester tonight. I like, Rochester's going to have the size advantage.
Definitely in the post.
And I think that, that should be enough to help them carry them through for a victory. The way we've seen Kennedy play in a couple of the games that first week, and if Morgan can, continue to do the things, and Macy Brown that they've been doing at the beginning of this season, I think that'll be a good show for the Lady Zebras tonight.
JV game tonight, Rochester ended basically a two-year losing streak. They defeated Peru tonight 26-15. Catherine Hughes had 7 points for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Rochester in their home whites, Peru in their road blacks. It'll be Dahlquist and also Stone, I believe, to jump center here at Rochester. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Play underway, and Peru wins the tip. Thompson on the right elbow, kicks it out here to Crow. Feeds down low to Stone. Stone double-teamed the post, and she's going to have it taken away by Musselman. Gives to Shively. Shively to Morgan Ruff, and here come the Rochester Lady Zebras.
And that's just the thing Rochester needed to do, is get the turnovers early. And boy, Stone turned around and ran right into a brick wall, and Musselman and Kennedy just took the ball away from her.
Is Peru in a box and one? I think they are in a box and one, and Kennedy's being chased. She's the one.
She's being double-teamed, yeah.
Ruff for three, no good. The rebound to Shively. Shively grabs the basketball, and we're going to have a tie-up. It's going to stay with Rochester, baseline left.
And that doesn't surprise me at all. We talked about that earlier. Peru was there to scout Rochester when they played CMA, and Kennedy went off. She scored every single point for Rochester in that first half. She had 19 points and 17 boards, so they're not the least bit surprised that they're well aware of who she is.
Dahlquist down low. Her jumper is no good, but a foul coming on Peru. That's going to send the 6-foot junior to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Well, you know, if you want to chase Kennedy around, that's going to leave Emma, and that's going to leave McKee all alone on the block.
Right, and, Peru doesn't start anybody over 5'10". Rochester with 2 6-footers on the floor.
Dahlquist finds the first one, lets it fly, and it rolls off, no good. One more coming for the junior. No score here at Rochester, about 40 seconds into the game. Emma Dahlquist will have one more for Rochester. That foul was on Drew Thompson. Noticed that. Yeah. That's a big deal.
Yeah.
Dahlquist eyes the second one, lets it fly. This one's good. 1-0 Rochester. And the freshman Crow will walk it through the center circle. Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone defense. Works right side to Thompson behind the arc on the right wing. One dribble, ball tipped away, ball loose. Rochester scrambling for it. We're going to have a tie-up, and Peru will keep possession. I like that Musselman and Shively both on the floor go for that loose basketball. Stone, unfortunately, took the brunt of it.
She had crunched in between the two.
So it'll be baseline right. Prescott will look to trigger it in around Musselman. Bounce pass into Stone. Stone stops. Pull up 10-footer, no good. Weak side rebound to Ruff. Mo rips and runs for Rochester. Up 1-0. Minute gone to the first quarter. Ruff through the center circle. Top of the key. Works right side. Now the paint. Caught by the defense. Ball loose on the floor. We're going to have another tie-up. Rochester will keep possession underneath.
Well, Morgan that time got in a little deep into the traffic. He figured if Musselman's going to draw two defenders, they got to find the open player.
Ruff to look it in, get it in, baseline right. Mo slaps the basketball. Mo looking over the top of the defense to Shively.
Yeah.
Shively drives it left. Now back to Mo for a three, right baseline, no good. Weak side rebound by Peru. And Crow rips.
That's the one Morgan's got to get, that wide open three-pointer in the corner.
Crow for three, right wing, no good. Offensive rebound to Stone. Stone has a block from Musselman. She gets her own rebound. Back to Crow. Her jumper from the elbow is no good. And Shively lets the basketball go out of bounds. Rochester going to get it back. Six and a half to play first quarter.
That last possession, Musselman was triple teamed on the post, and when the shot went up from the corner by Ruff, there was two girls blocking her out.
1-0 Rochester. Six and a half to play in the first quarter. Rochester, the basketball going to our left. Ruff through the center circle. Drifts to her right side, gets a pick from Musselman, drives left. Jumper from the left elbow on the way is no good. And the rebound being tipped around, Pruitt comes out of there with it.
I like both of those shots that Morgan's had.
Yep.
They're wide open,
yep.
One from the corner for three and one from the free throw line. We're going to have to start knocking them down.
Crow with the basketball, Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone. Prescott to Malone. Malone in the right corner out to Thompson. Drew Thompson, right wing, cut off by the defense, holds the basketball, baseline pass to Malone. Back to Thompson, right wing, three on the way for Peru. He is no good off the back of the rim, and Ruff with another board. Morgan rips and runs for Rochester. Lady Zebras up 1-0, 5:50 to play in the first quarter. Ruff gets a pick, works to the right wing. Now sends left side to Shively. Shively, bounce pass to Dahlquist. She'll take the 15-footer, no good, in and out, and the rebound to Peru.
I'd rather see Shively take that 15-footer and have Dahlquist underneath for the rebound.
I agree with that. So Peru with it, high on the left side. Tigers now to Malone, top of the key. Make that to Thompson. Now to Crow. Crow behind the arc in the left corner, down the baseline to Malone, top of the key to Thompson. Thompson drives it inside the three-point line, now pulls it back outside to Prescott. Prescott bounce pass to Stone. Her jumper from the baseline, no good. And the weak side rebound to Peterson. Karina clears it to Moe. Rochester runs, up 1-0. Here comes Macy Brown for the first time tonight.
Get another long-range three-point shooter in the ballgame. Peru's giving us that shot. We just haven't made it yet.
Peterson in the corner has her pass stolen by Thompson. Drew Thompson, left side of the floor. Now pulls up at the free throw line. Jump on the way. He's in and out. No good. Offensive rebound to Malone. There's got to be a travel there.
Yeah.
Peru is fighting over the rebound. And they travel. He's going to give it back to Rochester. Right now the Tigers, Bradley, beating the Zebras up and down the floor.
Yeah, they are. They're playing with a lot more aggression, doing a lot better blocking out for the rebounds. Rochester's got the height, but they're not taking advantage of it on the boards.
4:45 to play first quarter. Lady Zebras leading 1-0. Ruff. Left wing to Macy Brown. Down low to Dorcas. She puts it in for two.
That's
nice,
a nice
look.
Yeah, nice look by the freshman Brown. She's able to get it in to Dahlquist, opposite of the defensive pressure. And all Dahlquist had to do was turn around and put it in off the glass.
Crow has her pass kicked away by Ruff, and it'll stay with Peru. 3-0 Rochester, 4.5 to play in the first quarter here at Rochester High School.
And I like the way Brown did that, just a freshman, but when she caught that ball, she was in that, what you call that triple threat position. She could have dribbled. Matter of fact, I thought she was shooting the ball.
I did too.
But she was actually throwing it down low to Dahlquist.
Thompson into Prescott. Prescott against Musselman, looks back door to Stone, then has it stolen away by Ruff. Morgan, right side of the floor. Moe will go coast to coast and is fouled from behind by Stone, I believe. That's going to be out of bounds to Rochester.
Kind of bailed her out. Morgan lost control of the basketball and was just trying to catch back up with her.
So Stone, Harmony Stone, will pick up that foul. It'll be the team second, and Morgan Ruff will look to trigger in baseline right. Gets it into Musselman, and she loses it off of her hands. Picked up by Peru. Turnover Rochester.
Really not a good inbounds pass from Ruff, as Kennedy had two defenders right there.
Hit her hands, didn't it?
It might have, but she never would have been able to get her.
Lob pass to Malone. Malone against the double team. Out to Stone. She travels, no call. Down low to wide open Thompson. Thompson is fouled on the shot. Will that be on Musselman or will that be on Macy Brown? We'll wait and see.
It's going to be on Musselman. That's who's looking to read the number on her jersey.
Musselman.
So it's going to send Drew Thompson to the line for two for the Peru Tigers, and that's Kennedy's first foul. Can't do that. So Thompson, a right-handed free throw shooter. The senior eyes the first one, lets it fly off the back of the rim, and it falls through. 3-1. Rochester leads. 4 minutes to play first quarter. Thompson with one more for the Lady Tigers. Drew's second on the way for Peru's. No good off the back of the rim, and the rebound fall for is loose. Ruff picks it up and runs. Moe slows up, now heads across the timeline, works to the right wing. Ruff down middle of the floor. Between the rings, works to the left side of the floor. Bounce pass in the corner to Peterson. Peterson, law pass into Dahlquist. Emma then is fouled before the shot on the floor. And I believe that'll be Stone's foul. We'll wait and see. Nope. Prescott.
That foul's on Prescott, her first team third. And again, the ball going down low on the blocks to Dahlquist, and four defenders for Peru around that low block.
Peterson picks it up in the backcourt right in front of the Rochester bench. And now dribbles it across the timeline. 3:45 to play first quarter. She bounce passes to Moe. 3-1 Rochester.
2-3 Ruff
high on the right side.
2-3 zone by Peru.
Dahlquist with the inbounds pass. Now a little muscle in her. She puts up and in for two. Kennedy kind of got a deflection basket there as it was too high for Dahlquist. Off her fingertips right to the hands of Kennedy, who's at the right place at the right time. It's 2-1. Make that 5-1 Rochester. Crow, bounce pass to the near side. Now to Stone, to Malone. Malone then has it tied up. Kennedy's lucky she didn't pick up foul number two there.
Nice job as Malone put the ball up on her shoulder. Musselman just grabbed a hold of it, tied her up long enough to get the call.
3:14 to play first quarter. Peru basketball to bounce baseline rights. Prescott will look to trigger it in. Prescott looking to try to get it in around Musselman. Still looking. He's got to hurry. That's got to be close to five. There it is.
Nice job by Musselman. She's big enough. Just stand there and wave her arms. Makes it hard to get the ball in over top of her.
Peru will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zeebo Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
30-second timeout.
Oh, they gave him the timeout.
3:14 to play. Oh, they did. No, they didn't. He took a timeout after the count. No, they didn't. You're right.
Oh, man. We thought they were calling the five-second count. They called the timeout instead.
Pass into Stones. No good. Musselman grabs the board. That's a foul in many areas. Yeah. Not here, I guess. 5-1. Rochester with the lead with 3:05 to play in the first quarter. Now Peru, like Brad said in the previous trip, in a 2-3 zone. Musselman in the left corner, right in front of the three-point line. Now to Macy Brown on the right wing. Bounce pass back to Moe. Look to the three, pass it up. Works to the right side. Bounce pass to Brown. Three's in and out, no good. Rebound fall for Peterson's. Put back is good.
Nice job by Peterson and a good job by Brown, even though she missed the shot. Rochester, Moe, Ruff, and Brown need to put up those three-pointers to open up that post-game down low for Rochester.
Totally agree. Prescott between the rings, right side to Crow. Bounce pass to Stone. Ball tipped away right to the hands of Musselman. Kennedy grabs the ball and gives to Moe.
Again, great job by Peterson.
Moe right through the center circle. Drifts to the left side against the 2-3 zone. Up by six with 2:15 to play in the first quarter. And the pass is tipped out of bounds by Crow. And coming into the game is Richardson for Peru. And Sierra Weathers comes in for Rochester and replaces Emma Dahlquist.
Well, you see what Rochester's doing against that 2-3 zone. They only had Dahlquist before she came out of the game, was down low, but Musselman was out wide, way wide.
Yeah. Musselman gets the inbounds pass from Weathers, backs her way in, throws up a shot, it's good!
Right now, Peru does not have an answer if Kenny Musselman can get her hands on the basketball.
That was a good inbounds pass. I think it surprised everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Thompson around the defense, now backs it out between the rings, works right wing to Richardson. Richardson looking back pass to the middle, is cut off by Ruff. Thompson for three, no good, and Musselman fighting for the basketball. Weathers hits the floor and knocks it out of bounds.
She did a good job diving for it and then kicked it out of bounds with her knee.
Out of bounds to Peru, baseline right. 1:49 to play in the first quarter. Peru make that Rochester up 9-1. Thompson will look to trigger it in around Peterson. Thompson looking. Lob pass in to Malone. Now quickly to Richardson behind the arc on the right wing. Top of the key to Crow. Swings left side to Thompson. Down to 100 seconds to play in the first quarter. Thompson, 18 footers good over the defense. And she's got all three of Peru's points. It's 9-3.
All nine of Rochester's points have come in the paint.
Well, why not?
Yeah.
I mean, we're taller than four or 5 inches.
You're right. Yep.
Brown, left wing, back to Ruff. And I think Coach Stasiak wants to run some clock here. Corner to Peterson. Lob pass to Musselman. Kennedy, one bounce, loses the handle. Ball loose on the floor. And we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to stay with Rochester.
Probably an ill-advised attempt to dribble the ball.
I agree.
About 4 feet away from the basket, he probably could have just put it up off the glass.
Yep. So Allie Harsh comes in for the first time, and she'll give Kennedy Musselman a blow here with 1:14 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up by six at 9-3. Ruff looking to trigger it in. Over the top of the defense to Brown. Brown to Weathers, back to Ruff. Ruff in the right corner, drives the baseline, and she's going to be whistled for travel.
She had the right idea.
1:10 to play. First quarter, Rochester up 9-3. The Peru Tigers with the basketball going to our right. Crow crosses through the center circle for the Lady Tigers. Works left wing against Ruff. Outside to Thompson. Thompson against Weathers. Takes her to the right baseline. Cut off by the double-team defense. Now top of the key to Crow. Crow feeds it down low, and it's going to be last touch out of bounds by Rochester. And it's going to stay with Peru baseline right as that pass was intended for Malone. And Rochester kind of bailed him out there. So Prescott will look to trigger it in baseline right. Rochester up by six with 55 seconds to play in the first quarter. Bounce pass into Malone as she puts it in off the glass and for two, an easy two. And it's 9-5, Rochester, 45 seconds to play in the first quarter.
I think you'll see Rochester play for the last shot here in the quarter.
Left side to Brown, stands behind the three-point line. Yeah, I hear you. To Weathers in the right corner.
That won't happen again. Thompson will steal it.
Has her pass taken away by Crow. Crow in the middle of the floor. Here comes Peterson in the back door, tips it out of bounds. And it'll stay with Peru, 27 seconds to play in the first quarter. You can't make that the right wing pass to the left wing there.
A little and a little lazy pass across the top of the key. Thompson will take the next one. They do that.
Thompson around the defense. Pull up 10 footers off the back of the iron. No good. Ball being tipped around. Peru comes out of there with it with 20. Prescott backs it out to Richardson. She'll take a wide over 10 footer. It's short. Gets her own rebound. Put back is good. No good. But a foul coming on Rochester. And that's going to send Richardson to the line to shoot two freebies. And Peru on that trip, Brad, had about three offensive rebounds.
Yeah, Brown going to pick up her foul. Team second. Yeah, Rochester's got all their size sitting on the bench right now. I think Coach Stasiak looking to try and preserve a late quarter penalty.
Yeah. So Megan Nile will come into the game for the first time for Rochester as Richardson misses her first freebie. Macy Brown will come in the game. They'll come out of the game, that is. One more coming for Richardson. Somebody needs to put a butt in Peru and get him out of there so somebody can get a rebound, so somebody in white can get a rebound. Richardson, second one for the Tigers on the way. It's good this time. 9-7, Rochester. 12 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Morgan Ruff through the center circle. 2-3 zone with 9. Ruff at the volleyball line with 8. Drives it right with 6. Goes to the basket. Shot no good, but a foul coming on Stone. And with 4 seconds, Ruff will go to the line to shoot 2 for Rochester. Did I say 9-7? It's 9-6. I beg your pardon.
Fouls on Peru number 24, Malone first.
So Ruff at the line to shoot 2 for Rochester. Lady Zebras up by 3 with 4 seconds to play in the first quarter. Moe's first one is good. Nothing but net. She'll have one more. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Lady Zebras up by 4. Time ticking away here in the first quarter. Second one by Ruff is good again. Rochester up by 5. Richardson will look to trigger it in. Goes so to Crow with 3. Crow travels, no call with 2. And that's going to run out the clock in the first quarter. After 1, Rochester leads 11-6. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Lyle able to get it down low to Marshall on him.
Shot's good and a foul.
Yes.
So Kennedy will go to the line to see if she can give Rochester back a one-point lead.
Stone's going to pick up her second foul.
Can they have six?
Yes.
Kennedy Musselman at the line to shoot one free throw after the three-point play. We're knotted at 13 here, 5.5 minutes to play in the first half. Musselman. Kennedy has a free throw, lets it fly. It's a flat free throw, and luckily it went in. We'll have a discussion about that.
Bucket and free throw by Musselman ended a 7-0 run by Peru.
Peru takes a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Eagle Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Musselman. And Rochester going to be in a 1-2-2 half-court trap the way it looks.
Yeah, and again, that bucket and free throw by Musselman ended a 7-0 run by Peru to start the second quarter.
Kennedy has 7 of the 14. Crow over the top to Mungosa. Down low, shot on the way for Peru is good. And that's Stone with the bucket. And Peru back up 15-14. Ruff will jog it through the center circle. Peru is either in a 2-3 or a box and one. Well, Musselman gets a pass down low. She puts up for two. Good injury pass by Karina Peterson.
Yep. Peru's in a 2-3 zone until the ball goes down low. Then it's 4-on-1.
Outside to Mungosa. Then on the entry pass, Kennedy knocks it out of bounds. Great job by Musselman. Here's what I think about that. She was trying to kind of front.
Mungosa was boxing her, posting on the block, and Kennedy came around
and got around the front. Yep.
Was able to get that
without a foul.
Yeah. Able to get a hand on it.
16-15 Rochester. Prescott looks to get it in. Bounce pass to Crow. She travels.
Ooh, yeah.
Just give me a whistle. I can do it from here.
Right? Right?
4:50 to play in the first half. Rochester by one. And Mo will walk it through the center circle. Now they're going to play in front and behind Kennedy on that right block. Entry pass down low is tipped away, picked up by Peru, and Crow runs right side of the floor for Peru. Crow will go coast to coast, and her shot is no good, but a foul coming on Ruff.
Wow.
And that's going to send the freshman, Cortland Crow, to the line to shoot two for the Lady Tigers.
Ruff picks up her first, team third.
Yeah, if we're going to foul, we can't let them shoot.
Yeah.
And that was almost a three-point opportunity.
Number 11, Crow
at the line to shoot two for Peru. Rochester up by one at 16-15. The first one for the freshman on the way is no. No good, one more coming. Looking to knock this score up at 16 with 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Second one for Crow on the way, no good. Rebound fall for Musselman comes down with it. I wish she and Dahlquist wouldn't fight over it, and that's not Emma's problem. Ruff to Shively. Mo on the left wing. Bounce pass to Ruff on the left side. Now brings it to the top of the key. Backs it up the volleyball line. Now accelerates to the free throw line. Now Mo make that shot. He picks up the loose ball, and then she turns it over again. Off to Crow. Crow runs for Peru. Lob pass down low to Prescott. Layup is no good. Rebound to Ruff. Ruff with the basketball. Ruff middle of the floor. Now accelerates around the defense. And now left wing for Mo as she backs it out and resets for Rochester. Around Thompson, kicks it out to Peterson. Peterson back to Thompson, make that to Ruff. Now to Shively. Mo on the left wing. Bounce pass to Ruff, top of the key. 3:50 to play, first half, Rochester by one. Ruff drives the left side hard, and she's going to be fouled by Thompson, which will be number two on Drew Thompson.
Fouls on Tiger, number five, Thompson, for second, team six.
Dahlquist comes out of the game. Macy Brown back in. 3:46 to play, first half. Rochester up 16-15. And the inbounds pass comes into Ruff. Mo, middle of the floor for Rochester. In the corner to Shively. Shively with double teaming. Musselman was approved on the blocks. High on the right side of Ruff.
They got three defenders guarding Musselman on the block.
And now Coach Stasiak will want a timeout. It'll be a 30. You're listening to Ladies Eagle Basketball, 92.1 WROI. He and I will kind of banter about it and preview kind of the guys' season, which starts next Wednesday night here with the Culver Cavaliers.
Great.
So you'll want to stay tuned for that. 16-15. Rochester, 3.5 to play in the first half.
Triple team against Ruff with the basketball.
Mo around the defense, kicks it outside to Brown. Macy loses the ball, bounce pass to Musselman right at her feet, can't pick it up, and Peru picks it up. Crow with the basketball. Crow runs. Bounce pass out to, yes, Prescott, and she traveled.
Yeah, right now Rochester needs to be aware of the fact that Peru is only guarding two people on Rochester's offensive team, Ruff and Musselman. So what that says is Peterson and Brown and Shively need to get a little more offensive.
Moe walks it through the center circle. Rochester will clear it out a little bit. Gives to Macy Brown, quickly to Shively. Shively bounce pass to Musselman into the double team.
Forcing it into a double, around the defender on her and into the double team on Musselman.
Kennedy was able to force a tie up.
That's not a good decision there.
So Weathers comes back into the game and Shively to sit.
That's a situation where you got to dribble that back out the top of the key and spread the defense out, create a passing lane. You can't just force one in.
Bounce pass to Macy Brown. Brings it to the top of the key, over the top of the defense to Weathers on the right wing. Weathers lobs it into Kennedy. Nice hands by Kennedy. Gives to Peterson. Her jumper's no good, but a foul coming on Crow. And that's going to send Peterson into the line to shoot two. Love me some post-to-post passing. Love it.
That'll be the first on Crow, the seventh team foul.
2:50 to play in the first half. Karina Peterson at the line to shoot two for Rochester with 2:50 to play in the first half, leading by one, 16-15. Peterson eyes it, flies it, no good.
At the line for Rochester, 34, Peterson.
One more coming for Peterson. They're looking to stretch this lead to two. Second on the way, off the glass and in. 17-15. JV won tonight. Beat Peru 26-15. Brown guards Crow. Her jump in the lane. High off the glass. No good. Musselman on the board. And she clears to Ruff. Kennedy's approaching a double-double.
Yeah.
Needs to, really. Ruff, top of the key. Directs traffic. Stands at the volleyball line. Left side to Weathers. Gives to Musselman. Throws it away. Right into the hands of Stone. Stone, pull-up jumper. Make that Malone. No good. Thompson with the rebound. She has it taken away by Ruff. Moe runs down the middle of the floor. Moe high on the right side for Rochester. Now gives it the corner to Weathers. Weathers looking for Kennedy. Gives to Peterson. Throws it away again. It's going to be a tie-up. And Rochester going to turn it over.
Right now, Rochester having a hard time seeing those black jerseys for Peru because that's the third time down the floor we've thrown it right to them.
Here's the problem. In practice, those passes are open, especially when you're competing against no one. They're not open right now.
You're right. Yep. They're more focused on running an offense than they are taking what the defense gives you.
17-15 Rochester. 2 minutes to play first half. Crow, jump stop. Out to Prescott. She'll take an 18-foot over Musselman. It's good. And we're tied at 17 with two to play in the first half. Ruff jogs it through the center circle. Looks like a 1-4 type of defense now.
Yeah, it is. They're very, very intent on stopping that low post basket, low post game, and Rochester just not recognizing it from the outside.
Peterson with a long jumper, no good, and the rebound to Peru. 100 seconds to play in the first half. We're tied at 17, and Crow brings it up the floor for the Tigers. Crow works against Brown. Right side to Prescott. Prescott a long three right wing is no good. Dahlquist with a weak side board. She hands off to Ruff.
Right now I think Brown and Ruff have got to do more to open up the outside shot. They're open. Peru's not really putting a lot of pressure on them.
And another turnover on Rochester traveling. And Allie Harsh will come back in as Coach Stasiak looking to find the answers.
That's the eighth turnover in this second quarter alone for Rochester. Most of them unforced.
1:18 to play in the first half. We're tied at 17 here at Rochester High School. The Lady Tigers with the basketball going to our right. Crow, crossover dribble. Is going to be fouled on the reach-in. Is that going to be on Harsh?
Yeah.
No. She was around Harsh. There's no way that was on Harsh. Oh, it's going to be.
That's her first team fourth.
Prescott will look to trigger it in. Baseline left. 70 seconds to play in the first half. We're tied at 17. Prescott looks. Looking. Looks back door to Malone. Malone, jumper over the defense, no good. Harsh with the rebound. She gives to Ruff. 60 seconds to play first half. Rochester and Peru tied at 17. Peterson, law pass down low to Dahlquist. Too high, picked up by Thompson. Thompson pushes for Peru. Thompson is fouled on the shot. Is that going to be Ruff's second? That's going to, regardless, it's going to send Drew Thompson back to the line to shoot two.
You just cannot throw the ball or that lob when you have two defenders behind the offensive player.
Her second, team fifth at the line.
So Drew Thompson at the line to shoot two for Peru with 51 seconds to play in the first half. We're tied at 17. The senior's first free throw is good. One more coming for Thompson as Maddie Shively will come back in the game. Shively will replace Emma Dahlquist. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Peru back up 18-17, 50 seconds to play in the first half. Thompson's second one on the way is no good. A defensive rebound for Ruff. Moe with the basketball quickly across the timeline, 45 seconds. Ruff right wing, dribbles the left side, out to Shively. Shively drives the baseline for Rochester, cut off by the defense and throws it away, and Ruff put just to pick that foul number three.
Yep.
Foul on 32, Ruff.
I'm not sure if they keep track of individual turnovers, but there's been too many there. Well, Macy Brown comes back into the game, and Ruff will come out.
Unfortunate for Ruff. She's going to be chewed out for picking up that third foul, but it really wasn't her fault. It was a bad pass.
Bad pass to start with.
And she was just trying to get, you know, that hustle instinct. You know, she's trying to get there to save that bad pass from being a bad pass, and unfortunately, she gets a body foul.
28 seconds. Peru with the lead, 18-17. Prescott, top of the key. Bounce pass behind her to Crow. Crow works left side, gets a nice pick from Stone. Down to the baseline to Richardson. Richardson, a couple of dribbles to the left elbow, gives him the corner. To Stone. Stone, jumper over Musselman is good. 20-17 Peru might be the biggest lead of the night for Peru.
It is.
Macy Brown across the timeline with five. Bounce pass to Shively with three. Three on the way with the buzzer, no good. Actually, the rebound put back by Macy Brown is no good. At halftime, Peru leads 20-17. You're listening to Ladies Even Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Wheels completely came off that second quarter.
Wow.
Touchdown for the Pop Shoot, sponsored by Basketball Moms. Dollar a shot, make the shot, win a pop.
So sorry for this inconvenience, but
fouls on number 11,
the battery will not be able to cover the second half of the game. Again, our transmitter is run out of battery. We apologize for this inconvenience, and we hope that you enjoy the rest of the game. Thank you.
Possession Tigers.
Stone. Her third, team, second of the half.
Foul coming on Peru. 33 Stone, her fourth. Team fourth. At the line, shooting two. 4-0 is 44 Muscle. Substitution for Rochester. 54 Dahlquist. And for
Peru. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Isaac Smith of RTC-TV4. Unfortunately, the transmitter to WROI has died, so I will be providing the commentary for the rest of the game for you. Right now, Rochester is in the lead, 24-22, with Kennedy Musselman nailing a free throw. Now, this game is a Lady Zebras basketball game against the Peru Tigers and the Rochester Lady Zebras. If you just join us, I am Isaac Smith of RTC-TV4. Again, apologies for the inconvenience in advance. Right now, right now, it is 25-22 with Rochester in the lead. Brew with the ball, five with the shot, missing. Ball goes back to Rochester. 34 of Rochester. Passing to 12 of Rochester. Rochester passes to 24 of Rochester, who passes to Musselman, who passes to Dahlquist. Dahlquist with the layup. It is no good.
Zebras.
And
Dahlquist. Team second.
Dahlquist with her first foul. Possession of the ball goes to the Lady Tigers. 22 of the Lady Tigers passing to 21. Not 21, 11. Now 25 of the Lady Tigers with the ball. Travel. Now Peters. Now Peterson with the ball. And a switch in between number 12 and Ruff and Morgan Ruff. Now Ruff, 32 with the ball. 3 minutes 55 seconds to go in the third quarter. 24 of Rochester to Dahlquist to Musselman. Broken up by Peru. And the pass to number 5 of Peru. 5 of Peru to 11. To 25 of Peru. A nice swat by Musselman. Ruff now with the ball. Dribbling down at the three-point line. Passes to 24 of Rochester. Back to Ruff. Ruff dribbling to Musselman. Musselman with the shot. The two-pointer. 27-22, Rochester. In case you just joined us, I am Isaac Smith of RTC-TV4. RTC's transmitter to WROY has unfortunately died. And so now RTC will continue the rest of the game. So now Musselman back to Ruff. Peru attempted to score some points, but Rochester made sure they did not on that possession. Now Ruff with the ball. Eyeing up her opponent. Passes to 24 of Rochester, who passes to Dahlquist. Takes a few steps with the shot. Goes over. And now 11 of Peru with the ball. Dribbling to the right side of the field. And 30, and Peterson to Ruff. Ruff with the ball. Ruff to Peterson. Peterson back to Ruff. Ruff to 24. 24 to Dahlquist. Dahlquist to 24. 24 to Ruff. Ruff to Peterson. Peterson flanked by two Brew team members, and now off to Ruff. Ruff to 24. 24. Back to Ruff. Foul called. The call appears to be on Peru, the second of 24. A minute 28 left to go in the third quarter. And Rochester with a less than comfortable lead, but a lead nonetheless. Peterson to Ruff. Ruff dribbling the ball. Ruff to 12. 12 to Peterson. Ruff to 12. Back to 12 again. Back to Peterson. Peterson to Ruff. Ruff eyeing her options. Ruff engaging with Peru 5. Ruff with the ball to 12. 12 to 32. To Ruff 32. Almost goes to Peru. Ruff picks it. Peterson picks it up and passes it back to Ruff. Ruff with the ball. With the shot. Almost. The ball broken up. And Rochester knocked the ball out with 33 seconds left to go. Peru has the ball.
10, Weathers.
Now, Peru with the ball. The Lady Tigers are down by 5. And with roughly 8 minutes left, Musselman stealing the ball back. However, a foul has been called.
Foul's on zebra number 10, Weathers. her first at the line, shooting two, Thompson.
And the first foul of 10 for Rochester. That will result in 2 3 throws for Beru. And Beru nails the first one. It is now 27-23 with 21.5 seconds left to go.
Substitution for Rochester, 32, Ruff.
Now, Ruff with the ball. And both free throws have been nailed by Beru. And with the buzzer, Rochester attempted to get a few more points in. And now Rochester leads by 3 going into the fourth quarter. You are listening to RTC TV4. We will be back with the conclusion of this game. And welcome back to the finale of this game between regular season game between the Beru Lady Tigers and the Rochester Lady Zebras. Once again, I am Isaac Smith of RTC TV4, and we are back in this game. Beru now with the ball. The score is 27-24 with a little under a quarter left. An attempt by 3, no good by Beru. Musselman with the ball. Passed it to Ruff. Ruff now with the ball. Passing it to 12. Back to Ruff. Back to 12. Back to Ruff. Back to 12. And 12. Passing it to 24. 24 to 12 to 32. 32. Ruff with the shot. The 3. Rochester Lady Zebras double their lead into a much more comfortable 6 points. Currently, right now, in this point of the season, the Beru Lady Tigers are 1-4, and the Lady Zebras are winless, 0-4. They hope to end that tonight. As WROI was mentioning at various times during this game and in the pregame, turnovers have been a bit of an issue for the Lady Zebras. But tonight, there haven't been nearly as many as the one in Oak Hill. Now, Beru with the ball. Beru with the 3. Goes off the rim. Ruff with the recovery. Ruff biding her time. Eating away the clock. Waiting for her next chance. Ruff. To Musselman. Musselman manages to hold on. Doesn't make the shot, but the referees have called something. Let's see what it is. It appears, as my suspicions were correct, there was a foul, the third foul on number 5 for Beru. Musselman will get 2 free throws. The first free throw is good, extending the lead to 31-24.
33, Stone.
Musselman with the next free throw, and it is also good, extending the Rochester lead by 8. By 2, extending the Rochester lead of 6 by 2, and you get 8. 22 of Beru for 3, off the rim, but rebounding her own shot is 22. 11 of Beru tries to make a shot for 2, does not make it, and Ruff recovers the ball. Ruff now with the ball. Dahlquist fumbles the ball a little bit, but is recovered safely by Ruff. Ruff with the ball. And Ruff with a layup! And an extraordinary layup. That's what gets you here, folks. Practice, practice, and practice. And now Ruff will have a chance to extend the lead from 10 to a possible 11 or even 12. due to a foul by number 23 of Peru. And the ball rolls out of bounds. But a foul is called, and it appears that Rochester will keep the ball.
Fouls on 33 Stone.
33 of Peru.
Substitution for
has now has her fifth 33 of Peru having her fifth foul has now been ejected from the game. And her substitution is another member of Peru. Another free throw. This one also does not make it in. Rochester makes a substitution. Peterson for 24. Peru with the ball. Peru 3 passes. Passes to a fellow Peru member. 12 of Rochester's at a degree. Peru and Peterson breaks up the ball. There's a mad dash for the ball. And possession is deemed to be in Rochester's favor at around midcourt. That fall looked like it really hurt. A timeout has been called. We will take a short break. Don't go anywhere, sports fans. Welcome back, sports fans, to the exciting the final quarter of the matchup between the Peru Lady Tigers and the Rochester Lady Zebras. Right now, Ruff of Rochester, number 32, with the ball. Manages to bounce it after getting it swatted from a grab. Manages to bounce it to Peterson, who passes it back to Ruff. Ruff with the ball. And another layup. This time it hits the rim. And 5 of Peru making a mad dash, trying to get in some points. The shot. And it nothing but net. And the scoreboard says 36-24, but the score is actually 32-26. Now, 32. Ruff to 12, to Peterson, to 12, to Ruff. Ruff with the long pass to Musselman, and Musselman manages to make another two-pointer. The score now stands at 34-26. We're entering into the last few minutes of the game, and both teams are feeling the heat. Rochester desperately trying to get their first win, whereas Peru wanting to get a win against a team that has caused them so much, has gotten so many points in the past. But Peru manages to get a three-pointer, and the score now stands at 36-29. Rochester, again another pass. Kennedy Musselman's long arms are just enough to grab the ball one-handed, like in football, and manages to make the perfect two-point shot. Rochester maintaining their lead. A foul has been called.
Zebra foul. And it is
a zebra foul for Ruff. Her fourth. And just one more, and just one foul away from getting ejected. Not ejected, fouled out. And Viva Peru with the shot is taken down by Musselman. Musselman gives it to Ruff. Ruff. Now with the ball. Ruff. And a timeout has been called.
Timeout. Zebras.
By the Zebras. We will take a short break. Don't go anywhere, sports fans. Welcome back, sports fans, to the exciting conclusion of the game, of this game. Lady Zebras basketball game between the host Lady Zebras and the visiting Lady Tigers. Now, Ruff with the ball. 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the game. 12 of Rochester. Passes to 34 of Rochester. 34. To 30. Back to 32. Ruff. Ruff passing to passing to 12. 12 manages to make a full circle around, but Peru manages to get the ball back. And now, 5 of Peru making a charge, trying to get some points in. Peru, 2 passes and a stunning 2-pointer. Ruff, now with the ball. Just over 2.5 minutes left to go in the game. Ruff and Rochester making sure to maintain their 7-point lead or expand on it. Peru breaks up the pass, but a foul is called.
Foul coming on Zebras 44, Bussin on her second.
And Rochester has a foul called against them. It is Musselman, number 44's second. Peru now with the ball. Peru 5 with the jump shot. Musselman manages to reel the ball in, passes it to Ruff. Ruff now with the ball. 2 minutes left to go in the ball game. And Rochester up with a comfortable 7-point lead. But at this point in the game, anything can happen. Peterson passes to Ruff. The Lady Zebras are playing cat and mouse with the Lady Tigers. Right now, Peterson getting double teamed. Manages to pass it to Ruff. Ruff gets the ball swatted away from her, manages to pick it back up, tries to go for a behind-the-back pass to Peterson. Peterson is nowhere and ends up getting it for Peru. However, Peru has had something called against them, and the Lady Zebras will get the ball back. A minute 23 left to go. And a timeout has been called by Peru. We will be back in a little bit. Don't go anywhere for the exciting finale of this Lady Zebras basketball game. Welcome back, sports fans, to the exciting finale of the Lady Zebras basketball game between the host team, the Lady Zebras, and the away team, the Lady Tigers. We are just about to wrap this up. We're in the final 2 minutes. With a minute 23 left to go, Rochester holds the lead of 38-31. Valpo has been keeping it close throughout the game, and there have been numerous lead changes. Musselman to Peterson to 24 of Rochester, and muffs up the ball. 11 of Peru gets an easy layup in, and the lead has been cut to 5. Ruff now with the ball. Ruff trying to keep the ball away from Peru. And a foul has been called. And the call appears to be against the Lady Zebras. Peru 25 passes to Peru 11. Peterson trying to keep 5 at bay. Peru still has a chance. And 5. The 3-pointer just doesn't fall in. And 5 for Peru. The 3 also doesn't fall in. Now, Ruff with the ball with less than 30 seconds to go. 5 of Peru has no choice but to foul Ruff in order to give them a chance. Thompson with one foul before she gets... with one foul before she's fouled out. Rochester now has a chance to extend their lead and try and make it a 3-score game, which with 25 seconds left to go in the game is virtually impossible. The first one does not fall in. Peru, 11, trying desperately to get a score. 5, gets it swatted away by 44. What a play by Musselman. The ball is still in Peru's hands, but a swat is better than nothing. Peterson switches out for 22 of Rochester. With 16.8 seconds left to go in the game, the Tigers have called timeout. The score stands at 38-33. You're listening to RTC TV4. Welcome back to the exciting finale of the game of this girls basketball game between the Rochester Lady Zebras and the Peru Lady Tigers. The Lady Zebras, once dominant, now have fallen to 0-4, which is double their loss record of last year. Trying to get their first win. Peru trying to get their second. Both with four losses. Musselman with the ball. Gets it stolen by 11. And the referees have called something. 11 with just under 12 seconds left to go in the game. And the Lady Tigers still alive. With a shot at the free throw line. Trying to force this thing into overtime. And the shot is no good. Musselman. Ruff. Trying to make sure this ball game ends right here. 3-2. Just under 2 seconds. Just under 3 seconds left in the ball game. And number 11 of Peru has her fourth foul. 32, it would be an extraordinary miracle. It would take a full court shot and maybe a foul on Rochester in order for Peru to win. At this point, it's pretty much over. 39-33 Rochester with 2.6 seconds left to go. Ruff about to shoot the final free throw of the night. And she makes it. Rochester up 40-33.
Also checking in for
now.
Peru, 32 Schmitz.
Now.
And 3 Richardson.
Peru getting ready. Trying a last stitch effort with 2.6 seconds left to go in the game. Going from near half court, it misses. But what a valiant shot. Your final score tonight is the Rochester Zebras 40 and the Lady Tigers 33. The Rochester Lady Zebras improve to 1-4. The Lady Tigers fall to 2-1-5. You are watching and listening RTCTV4.com and WROI. Please, if you're watching this on YouTube, click that like button, and why not subscribe if you have a channel. Anyway, I'm Isaac Smith from RTC TV4. We will see you next time. Bye-bye.